Anyone who knows Shannon Sharpe knows that he's not afraid to speak what's on his mind. He's not afraid to get loud when he wants to. There was a time during a 1996 game between the Broncos and the Patriots that he phoned into the president because the game was that out of hand. Denver won that one 34-8. And there was the infamous incident where he forced Derek Thomas to commit 3 personal fouls in 2 minutes because Sharpe just kept reciting the phone number of Thomas's girlfriend. Sharpe is one of the best tight ends in NFL history. He's an 8-time Pro Bowler and a 3-time Super Bowl champion, and finished his career with over 10,000 receiving yards. But he's also one of the best talkers in NFL history. And after a 2000 game against the Pittsburgh Steelers, he used his time at the post-game press conference to actively give the Steelers advice. Seriously, the game was so bad and so ugly that, in a way, he felt so sorry for the Steelers that he tried to give them legitimate advice. And this is the story behind that. First, we need some context going into this game, because this is going to become extremely relevant for Sharpe's comments later on. It's September 3rd, 2000, and the Steelers are taking on the Ravens on opening day of a brand new season. Pittsburgh is coming off of a disastrous 1999 campaign, where they finished 6-10, which was not only the worst record of Bill Cowher's coaching career, but their worst record since 1988, when they went 5-11. If you want to learn more about a really funny meltdown that Cowher had during a game, click the video in the upper right corner. And the offseason was full of chaos and controversy, with a lot of infighting. Less than a week before the season started, Cowher announced that Scott Shields would no longer be the team's starting free safety. Shields was the biggest free safety in football. Literally, he stood at 6'4" and 228 pounds. He was drafted in the second round of the 1999 NFL Draft. But despite his size, the Steelers were unimpressed with his hitting ability, and they wanted him to overpower guys. He didn't impress the coaching staff in the preseason and in camp. And because of this, Cowher said that Brent Alexander, a free agent signing who started every game for the Panthers in 1998 and 99, was going to start at free safety instead. It's safe to say that Shields did not take the news well. Shields was upset and criticized the coaching staff publicly, saying, "I think they all know that I'm pretty upset, and I think they know where I stand." He then added, "When you're getting, we're happy with you, you're doing good, just keep working, you're getting better, and then they put you on the bench? It's really tough. On top of that, you have a quarterback controversy between Kent Graham and Cordell Stewart, which was won by Graham at the last minute following a tumultuous preseason where Stewart had a passer rating of just 39.8. Obviously, that divided the locker room a bit as well. It's rare to say this about the Steelers in the post-merger era, but in the week leading up to the 2000 season, they were legitimately dysfunctional. And now, they were playing the Ravens for the final time ever at Three Rivers Stadium to open the season off. The game was an absolute bloodbath. Baltimore held Pittsburgh to just 30 yards rushing on 18 carries. The Steelers didn't get a first down during the entire first quarter. Pittsburgh entered Baltimore territory just twice, and the Ravens won convincingly, winning it 16-0. It was one of those games where Pittsburgh could have been on the field for 60 more minutes, and they still would not have found their way into the end zone. After the game, as is to be expected in any rivalry game, there was some trash talking going on. Brian Billick, who had never lost at Three Rivers Stadium, said that he hates the fact that they're tearing it down, and that if they want to save some money and not finish that other stadium, I'll chip in a few bucks. Even Shannon Sharpe, who finished the game without a single catch, talked a bit about how this wasn't a rivalry, and how the crowd was super quiet. But Sharpe spent the bulk of his time during the press conference not talking about how well his team played or trash-talking the Steelers. Instead, he used his press conference to offer advice to Pittsburgh. Judging by the comments, he actually seemed angry that Pittsburgh was as dysfunctional as they were, and genuinely wanted to see them get better. Sharpe started off by saying, "The Steelers have some real problems that they need to have addressed. That's probably the worst in my 11 years that I've seen a Steelers team look. And I'm sure Bill Cowher is very disappointed, because they've got a lot of internal turmoil." And then, he continued by advising the players to shut up and do their jobs, and that they're embarrassing themselves and the organization. He said, "Your job is to go out there and play football, not to worry about who's playing." Steeler players going public about the lineup changes, as well as Sharpe working out with Steelers safety Lee Flowers in the offseason, made Sharpe well aware of these issues. Did Sharpe's pep talk help out a rival? Not entirely, as the Steelers finished the month of September without a win. However, the Steelers did finish the season 9-7, so even though they missed the playoffs, they did manage to turn it around after a rocky start. Heck, they even beat the Ravens 9-6 in the rematch in Baltimore. After that game, as you can probably guess, Bill Cowher didn't take too kindly to Sharp's comments, saying, "Can you guys please go tell Shannon Sharp that our problems here are fine?" Sharp is one of the most iconic talkers in NFL history, and this whole situation with the Ravens and the Steelers was just another example of that. It worked out in the end for him, as he won his third Super Bowl at the end of the season, winning Super Bowl 35 over the New York Giants. Sharp showed that season that not only was he a champion on the field, but he was a champion talker as well. Be sure to like this video, ring the notification bell, subscribe down below if you haven't already, as it helps the channel out a lot. And be sure to check out Twitch every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern for your chance to play NFL trivia and win cash prizes. Link in the description below. If you want to see videos like this condensed down to 60 seconds, then follow me on TikTok at JerryGator9 and subscribe to 60-Second NFL History on YouTube. Also, special thanks to all of our Patreon supporters for helping the channel. Your support is greatly appreciated. So you can become a patron and request future video topics in the description below.